Mars. It is the most studied planet in our solar system. As of August 2023, more than 50 Mars missions have been launched by countries around the globe. What is it about the red planet that draws such international interest and attention?
Mars is popular first and foremost because it's the thing that's kind of within reach. The rest of the universe seems immutable and distant and sort of out there. Mars is just on that boundary between reachable and completely alien.
It has a landscape that speaks to us. It looks like the pristine deserts that we have on the Earth. Mars looks like a place that would be quite manageable for us to inhabit. And there's this romance that is tied to this frontier-like landscape that is drawing us towards it.
Cape Canaveral, Florida, November 28, 1964. Atop an Atlas D booster, the Mariner 4 spacecraft launches on an 8-month journey to Mars. Its mission is to take the first pictures of the red planet. Mariner 4 and other Mariner spacecraft would spend more than a decade collecting data on our neighboring planets, Mercury, Venus, and Mars.
In the early 1960s, the space race was just beginning to heat up. America's answer to that was the Mariner program with a standardized spacecraft form. So you could build a number of different kinds of spacecraft that were more or less alike. You could send them to Mercury, you could send them to Mars, you could send them to Venus. And the idea behind the Mariner spacecraft was primarily to get the first look at these worlds close up.
Prior to Mariner 4's arrival to the Red Planet, our knowledge of the Martian surface was limited to conjecture and speculation. Did it have water? Did it have life? Could there even be Martians looking back at us? If humans were ever going to set foot on the planet, we'd need answers to these questions.
Mariner 4 to Mars was a big moment for astronomers and for the public at large, because for easily 100 years, we thought of Mars might have animals. We thought it might have oceans. Some people thought it might actually have people. Then Mariner 4 flies past 1965, and our world spins on a dime.
240,000 bits, representing the shading of 40,000 dots that will finally make up the first picture of Mars.
This whole imaginary red Martian empire is just crushed to dust. And we realize this place is just like the moon. It has a little bit more atmosphere. It's got more color to it. But it is just this bleak, rocky environment, and there's nothing else there.
Even though Mars was a barren desert landscape, scientists were encouraged to expand exploration efforts. And what they found in over six decades of intensive research could be the next frontier for human civilization.
When we look at the red planet above us, we see that there could be ice, there could be liquid water, there's carbon dioxide and dry ice there, and there could be an atmosphere if there was a little bit more energy added to Mars just the right way. So perhaps it also might offer us a future place to go as a new safe haven or expansion of humanity out into the solar system and into the stars. And so hopefully one day we're going to follow up those probes with actual people to go there and do some investigating and exploring.
Exploring the Martian frontier, however, will not be easy. In fact, it will be much more dangerous than the moon, because it's one thing to get there. But surviving a hostile planet may be harder than we think.
If you were to wander onto the surface of Mars unprotected, there are five things that will kill you. Within seconds, you're dead from the low atmospheric pressure. That didn't kill you. Within minutes, you would be dead from the fact that the Martian atmosphere is made of carbon dioxide instead of oxygen. We're brain dead within a few minutes without oxygen. The third thing that will kill you is the temperature. The temperature is extremely cold, minus 80 degrees Fahrenheit. You are frozen popsicle to the bone by sundown. If that didn't kill you, the fourth thing would be the dust. It's gonna clog your lungs. It's abrasive. It's gonna tear up the tissues of your lungs. Within a few weeks, you are dead from just being in contact with the dust. And finally, if that didn't kill you, space radiation. You don't have a thick atmosphere and you have no magnetic field. You're exposed to radiation. You're dead within several months to a few years.